Let's take a look back at the Newsweek now with the host of Triple J's Hack program, Sophie McNeill.
Hey.
Sophie, the National Disability Insurance Scheme was a big story this week.
It was, and disabled people and their families and their community were just stoked to see that the two parties came together. They eventually had a consensus. They had to work through a bit of stuff to get there, but we got there in the end, and so a lot of people were very happy this week. But on Wednesday, as the political argy-bargy was still going on, the Prime Minister's Twitter account started putting out some really weird stuff. This was this really interesting behind-the-scenes story. As a journalist, you're watching this happen. Mm. And they started getting really snarky with people who were questioning this levy to pay for this scheme and putting out some very strange tweets from the Prime Minister's official account. This was one of them. It was to a Conservative commentator. The Prime Minister's office meowing at someone saying, "Meow, have you checked Premier Newman's on-the-record comments on the levy?" So it was very weird. People started to wonder, is this the official account of the Prime Minister? Would she really be putting out this stuff? This is Karen Middleton, who works in the press gallery in Canberra. And they were asking her, you know, "Karen, are you able to verify for us? Is it legitimate? Is this a parody account?" But no, it is legitimate. This is actually the Prime Minister's official account. And one tweeter tweeted back at the Prime Minister's office and said, you know, "This is internationally embarrassing from an official Prime Minister's Twitter account to, you know, be meowing at people online." And they were getting pretty snarky if you were questioning their levy. So, yeah, it was a pretty funny development behind the scenes as this story unfolded.
Now, Tony Abbott, he got in trouble a little this week with his language about the budget.
Yeah, well, we heard earlier in the week about the government having $12 billion less in receipts. You know, that's how much less they're going to receive. They blame it on Treasury forecasts. The opposition uses this as an opportunity to say, you know, they can't manage the books and they're spending like drunken sailors. This is a favourite line of Tony Abbott's. They're spending like drunken sailors. He says it all the time. Mm-hmm. Apparently, this has really annoyed the Navy. Yeah. Ian McFedrin is the defence correspondent for News Limited, and he had this great article saying, you know, "Please, can Tony Abbott stop using this phrase, drunken sailors? It's offending the Navy. We're not like that anymore. This is not reflective of the modern day Navy." So, yeah, I thought that was pretty funny. And he's been asked, apparently, behind the scenes to stop using that phrase, drunken sailors, quite so much and offending the Navy boys.
What shall we do with them?
I don't know.
Now, big story this week out of America, really great story about the basketballer.
Yeah, Jason Collins, he's a famous centre who plays in the NBA, American Basketball League, and he came out as the first openly gay player in a big league in the States. It hasn't happened here yet in Australia either for someone who's currently playing, so it was a big news story in America and here as well. So he came out in Sports Illustrated magazine, and yeah, he was the first one. He said, you know, "If I had my way, someone else would have already done this. Nobody has. I'm raising my hand." And he received a lot of congratulations. People thought he was very brave to be the first one. And Michelle Obama, the first lady, tweeted at him saying, "We're so proud of you, Jason Collins. This is a huge step forward for our country. We've got your back, Michelle Obama." Okay. So, yeah, he received a lot of attention.
Barack Obama phoned him too, I understand.
Yes, he did.
Now, let's take a turn here for the worse, I guess I'll have to say. You saw a very interesting article this week.
Well, there was one article that caused a lot of uproar online. It was written by a retired Fairfax journalist called Jeffrey Barker. And he took aim at female commercial television ladies,
no,
Danny.
No.
So it was a bit mean. The article was called "Switch Off TV Babes for Some Real News." And Barker refers to what he calls talentless, perch-breasted reporters, female reporters on commercial TV news who don't know the world, let alone journalism. He said, "Their hair, usually blonde, tumbles artfully onto their shoulders. Their eyes, usually blue, sparkle brightly. Their complexions are perfect. Welcome to commercial TV journalism."
For shame. For shame. Well, to be a babe.
Many people were really offended, saying, "Look, this is so sexist. Why would you put this out there and basically say you can't be attractive and intelligent?" So just caused a huge stir on Twitter. You can imagine, not just commercial television ladies who are pissed off by this. A lot of people thought it was sexist.
Absolutely.
And opinion pieces started coming out. As soon as Jeffrey's piece was published, mm-hmm. he just got about 50 replies. This is one of them. Jacqueline Maley from the Sydney Morning Herald giving him a lot of crap there, saying how sexist he was being.
It's just an amazing thing to read and think, you know, because you wear lip gloss and do your hair and look attractive. I would do that if I wasn't a journalist. I would do that if I was a lawyer or a doctor. Or you can't be presentable and smart at the same time.
See, that's the beauty of radio. You don't have to do your hair.
Well, you're looking pretty wonderful with your blonde hair tumbling artfully tonight.
Thank you, Danny.
Thank you so much for being here this week.
No worries.